Here we have a beautiful graph given, which was totally not drawn in paint. And we are asked to draw the equivalent feature structure to this graph. Now, the first thing we want to do is to find the root of the graph. That means a node with only outgoing edges. In this case, it is that one. If you find two or more nodes with only outgoing edges, then you are doomed and you cannot draw a feature structure from it. Now this node will be represented by our outermost brackets. Now this node has three outgoing edges. That means the feature structure has three properties. And it doesn't matter in which order I write them down, so I can just pick the ones, the order I like to do them in. And I decide I want to start with that one. Here we have a complex property seam, which points to another node. So I add the property seam. And I represent the node it points to by a new pair of brackets. Now this node has another outgoing edge with the property actor, and it points to another node. So I add a new property actor. And the other node is represented by a new pair of brackets. But, as you can see, this node here has another incoming edge. So what I will need to represent this is a pointer. And it's like a little rectangle with a number in it. In this case, it's number one. I can just take anyone, and I usually go with the numbers, and I start with one. So now this node, well, I need some bigger brackets. So now this node here, it has one atomic property called Mary. So, I will add a new property name with the value Mary. But we are not done yet. The node has another outgoing edge course, which points to another node. So, I have to add another property, which is called course, and points to another node, so I will represent this by a new pair of edges. And here this node has no outgoing edges, so there are no more properties specified in it. But you can see that there's another incoming edge, so I need another pointer. I will write down a new rectangle, now with number 2 in it. And then that was this pass. Everything which is in color I did now, so these two properties are left. And I will now go with that one. Here we are back at the root node, which is represented by our outermost brackets. And here the feature structure has a new property actor. And actor points to this node, which I already drew here and where I used a pointer. So I can just save a lot of time and just write down the pointer here. Now, this property actor here points to the same node as its edge. And here the feature structure by the pointer points to the same property that's written down here. Then I need Then we have another property left for the root node, which is called cos. And cos points to this node where I also added a pointer to. So I will just write down the pointer here. And I am done. And this is the feature structure to this graph.